Hello and welcome to another episode of me painting again. Oh yeah, we're painting again. And this time, as you can see, I have a bit of a sketch going on here. In a bit of chalk. Just used a little bit of chalk. Just did a quick sketch. Nothing complicated. You can do it. Just use your brush. I was using my brush to measure about where placements were. Holding my brush like that and going boink on my reference picture, and then just doing it again on this one. And here is our reference. So this is a photo that I took, and some digital painting on it as well, to change it, because I didn't really like the background. I changed that. The face in the waterfall, and then this chap here. I may have been watching a lot of Lord of the Rings. Yeah, I'll move that over there. So I thought I'd design something, you know, pretend I'm working on the movie. You know, why not? Gotta pretend. And then I just got really inspired, and I ended up drawing that using the photo I took in Lake District, mixed in with my own digital artwork on top of it to create it. I really like it. I like the idea of a face in the waterfall, like as a water giant or something. And anyway, he's here, waiting. Well, he's in the search for something. Something precious. Right, let's start painting. So, the palette of colours. Not too many colours today. Blue, blue. I've got ultramarine blue, which I'm going to use the most of. And I put some Prussian blue on, but I tested it, and it was a bit of a greenish hint, which I don't mind for some of the grasses, I suppose. So I left it on. Some ivory black, just so I can... black. Get it on. Two whites, a soft white, and then a thicker white. I couldn't be bothered to mix any more thicker white, so I just left it like that. A little bit of red and a little bit of chrome yellow. It's not really a great deal on the palette. And a few brushes that I like because they were cheap. Graduate brushes mostly, filbert brushes mostly. Mostly. So anyway, let us start this painting off. And what I'll do, to make it easier for you to see, I will check my colours like so. Because what we need to do is get things in there. We got to make decisions as well. Are we going to paint this mass of a waterfall here in the darkest dark, or the middle, or the light? So you got to think, you're gonna be mixing on the canvas. So, because I'm going to start piling paint on, the lighter areas are going to be thickest paint, and the darker area, well, the middle area, it's probably going to be the thinnest, is what I'm going to go for. Stick a little bit of black in my blue, and we'll get this kind of colour almost. And then we can start adding lights. It's a bit like painting, well, it's like painting anything. You've got to make a decision, because this style of painting, you do it all, well, you try. To do it all in one go. It doesn't always work out, and sometimes you need to wait for it to dry and carry on. So there you go. The explanation is very easy. So mixing down here, just blue and black. Bit of ivory black, ivory black, and a bit of ultramarine blue. Now, I've said in the other videos, oh, you said you make your own blacks using burnt umber and... yeah, you said you make your own blacks using burnt umber and ultramarine blue. Well, what are you doing using black now? What is this magic? Magic, yes. Feeling magical today. yeah, and it is a good choice to make your own darks. But today, don't take me for a common painter. Today, we're doing something different. I'm scrubbing the paint. I'll leave a little bit of this. Just a bit. Because I don't want to... We've got the lights going there. Yes, don't take me for a common painter! Yeah, so today I... Because there isn't a great deal of colour, it doesn't bother me that I'm going to use black. If I was going to get a lot of colour, then I would be thinking, probably going to be more effective if I mix my own darks, where... Because this dark is not a variety of darks. No, it is not. So it doesn't matter. Does one understand what one means? I hope you do! Because I'm in the mood for magic. And I'm going to be painting like I'm a magician. I've not managed to put paint to canvas for a while because I've been doing a lot of overtime at work because I need the money. Why else? And so I'm quite excited to be getting the paints out and painting away. It's fun, isn't it? I really enjoy it. I think when you've painted a while and you haven't got that thought of, well, how do you do it? How do you put paint on the canvas? How do you do this? How do you do that? When that thought is all over of the how to do, which hopefully these videos might answer a few of the how-to-do questions, and then again, they may not. We can only try. But they may do. And if they do help you out with those how-to questions, then that's great, because it'll get you a bit further down the line. And that makes me happy because I'm helping out. I am helping, just like Gandalf helped the hobbits. But I don't see myself as a Gandalf character. I'm more like sorry, there's a cough. Gone. Yes, I'm more of the creepy one who's looking for this precious. I hope Peter Jackson isn't watching. He'll have me taken down off YouTube. I really enjoy rewatching the movies. So I added a bit of white in there, that you noticed, because the majority of the upper part of the waterfall is a bit lighter. So I started throwing in a bit more light.
then I can take it into darkness. Like Saruman.
Oh dear. This is going to be a fun one. This is either going to really get on people's nerves, me doing these silly impressions. Ah, who cares? This is a fun channel. We all do impressions. Right? So, move this further down. You can see the eyes. Flowing around the eyes. Try not to cover them completely so I can still see whereabouts they're supposed to be. Okay. Might go a little bit lighter in this bit. Lighter in this bit as well. Can stop, get some light in, get some of that flow going down. Yeah, it was quite hard to get this photo actually. I had to get myself right in there. But that's what I always do actually when I try and get good photos. I've got to try and get in a free angle. Making those sound effects to get you in the mood. That's why I do the impressions, do the sound effects, really get in the mood. Splashes, water, flying it out in there. Yeah, so I'm trying to keep it dull at the moment. I'm not going for the brightest brights as yet. And if you followed me a few times, you probably worked it out. I do like painting this way. So, I kind of stumbled across it when I was watching various painters. Well, reading a lot of books, and then it's funny actually, when I'm reading art books, for some reason in my own head it becomes more complicated than it is, when in fact it is just painting. Painting, 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 that's all it is. There's no complex, it is all in the mind. Hopefully, I won't be completely mad by the end of this painting. We'll still have some sanity. But while you're in the mood of magic and stuff, it doesn't matter. See, I really felt like getting that water in there. Beauty of oil painting, and I've not really been able to get the same level of control as any other medium than oils for myself. Anyway. Oil paints, they just seem to work with me. I can get that feeling of control. Enjoy it as well. I think that's what it is. I think if you enjoy the medium, I might do a live video. I want to do another live broadcast because I enjoyed talking about it last time. I might talk about mediums and my thoughts on different mediums. Because I do get a lot of questions about acrylics, and it's not a medium that I like using. Because I can't control it as much. And it's probably because I haven't used it as much as I've used oils. And then, of course, unless you've used something, I guess they're not going to be quite as proficient. But who knows, really? Obviously, it's all water. Oh yes, it's a waterfall. Of course, it's all water. A lot coming from up there. And now I'm kind of making this up a bit as well. I'm looking at the reference more so, messing around a bit. Everything here is looking pretty good. There is a dark which we can put back. Just use more paint, just pile that paint up. If you get an area where you look at it and you go, oh, I wanted that to be a bit darker or lighter, whatever, lighter or darker, just get a load more paint and just put it in. That's how you do it. Dark there, haven't we? Let's see if we can get some of that in other, a few of the other blah, 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 other places. Yeah. I quite dark there, I like that. Yeah. So we've got rock. We've got rock all the way up here. So you're probably thinking, why didn't I start at the back and work forward? Why have you started down here? Because at my art school, they've always said to us, when you oil paint, you start at the back, and then you work forward. Well, at the Jason Bowen Art School, we do whatever we like. Yeah. We know better because we're not professionally trained, so we are better. Yeah, it's definitely a question though, isn't it? Because, you know, maybe it would be better to do that. Maybe it would. But we don't mind. We don't like to give ourselves rules. We say to ourselves, whatever works is the way we'll do it. So if it's better for us to do it like this, then we'll do it like this. Putting in a few rocks here and there. Water. Think about all this. Making sure we've got a lot of rocks in there. Okay. We're just blocking in and blocking out. Grabbing a bit of blue. Blue and white, throw in the sky. Nice sky, nice blue white. There's a bit of black in there from my brush, but I'm not bothered about that really. quite thinly painted. So to get it a thin oil paint without using mediums to get it on the canvas, you have to scrub it. That's the trick to this technique. Rubbing paint. Now and then sit back, have a look. Oh. So take your time, otherwise, your shoulder will start burning. You don't want to be knackering yourself out. That looks quite good so far. Just mark that there, so we know where the teeth are. A bit of light on the eye. Anyway, we'll work on that because we don't want to be doing that yet. You get a bit carried away. What are you doing? Getting carried away. Need to keep moving. Keep painting. Keep painting. We're making ourselves a darker bluey black, a bit darker, because we want to do the mountain in the background. So we've got the peak there. Gets you in the mood. I do that sometimes when I'm painting stuff. I like put music on. For this, I had Lord of the Rings soundtrack on while I was painting on the computer doing my design. Now we've got some rocks in front.
some more dark colour.
Changed it a bit there, but never mind.
So with the light absorbing water then.
Go on to a little bit of the old, little bit of the Prussian blue in the colour, just to change it, because you get that kind of greeny blue, like that. Which works for the land, quite like that. It gives me something different flavour. Maybe a little bit of the bow for the blues, a little bit of that, a little bit of that. Amongst that, you get something different. More of the black in it. You get some shapes. Quite interesting. Finding some rocks in front of that. We're going to paint him in front of this as well, so don't need to worry too much. There's a lump of paint there from when my brush hit it. There can be a rock there. Okay, I'll sit back, have a look at that. Yeah, it's coming on quite nicely. There's some more dark there, more dark in there. Rock light. Oh, I was trying to think what that was. It's not water, it's rock. Where is it? Yeah, it's rock. Can be filled in there. We're getting rid of all the white, well, grey. And that makes it easier
for us to keep going with the painting.
So I'm going to throw in, I'm just doing various versions of white, black and blue. Various versions. So we've got trees here. Funny shaped magic looking trees. Make them better than the ones in the picture. Make loads of branches. Probably bring that tree forward a bit and make a bit more dark on it. Another one there. Just wiggle in the brush. Just wiggle the brush. It'll wiggle. These horrible, horrible trees. One there. We want them on the other side as well. Trees. Magical trees. Well, this is all about, this painting, magic, magic and mystery. Think about when you, well, this is what I do. I think about when I've been in the forest painting. Think about the trees I've seen. Branches go everywhere. Sometimes they pick up the light, sometimes they don't. Oh, we had a tree in the background as well. Whoa! Got yellow on the brush. No good. Put it back on the palette. Don't know how that happened. Painting. Is it coming on to the way you wanted? I think we're doing alright actually. I think it is coming on nicely. There's certain things that need improving. We need to put the bloke in. We need to change that shape of that rock, which I don't like. And the light will help change that rest of that actually. So let's put a rock in there. Okay.
this sort of magical looking blue amongst here. A little bit of kind of a texture to the ground. Works quite well, doesn't it? Just touching the brush, changing things, giving it something more than what it had. That's what we want to do. Rock. Just add a nice blueness to it. Nice blueness to the colour. Rock. We've got blue coming from above, lighting the rock, you see. Lots of ultramarine blue mixed in it. Sit back and have a look at it. Quite like it. Right, I think I'll start putting in this chap. This thing's putting in as well. This rock. Alright, so now we've just got that guy to do. Quite like that. I might put some more branches on that. Get some on this little brush. Something like that. I might put in a little bit of light. some like kind of rooty sort of look. Some of it needs darkening again. Okay, I like this. Sitting back, having a look. One of my magic round brushes. It's worn very badly, but I like it because of that. I'll put this bloke in, and then we can start adding a bit more light. And we can choose where we want the light. Because that's the thing, the magic about painting is what light you use and where. That's the magic. That's what I think. As soon as you start putting the light on, that's when the magic happens. Those magical highlights, really. Those things that you can't help but love doing. Try and think about the anatomy of your character when you're painting. Think about the rib cage here, and then the coat that's falling on top of it. I try and do that. Leg and the boot. What I've found myself doing now is watching people a lot. Watching how people stand, how people do things. It's really interesting. It gives you an idea of how to do your picture. Of course, the best one is watching yourself. You're watching yourself do things, that's a good way of improving. Oh, I haven't got any brown on my palette. Burnt umber. Dirty hair. Holding loads of brushes now. Bit of the burnt umber. We'll put his hair in. Might be good to do his face like that as well. What I'm thinking. the old burnt umber on the brush. Trying to clean things up a bit to make it more correct. Not far off. Use that to separate the legs. And a little bit of separation from the arm as well. Just so we can see it, you see. I want to be able to see. I think we could probably go with that, to be honest. Yeah, I'll go with that. I might just close in the area around the flame, and we can then paint on top. So you have to be a bit tricky here because you don't want to get into a mess. And it's really easy when you're painting to get in a mess. So you need to control yourself, hold back, don't go too crazy too soon. I say that because I know I always do. I'm always telling myself to hold back, hold back, hold back. Reminds me of the old, they always seem to do it in battle scenes in movies, don't they? Always like, hold! Oh, fight! It's a bit like that for painting. Keep holding back, and then boom! Right, let's put... I think we're going to need a different brush. Might be alright. Red and yellow, just red and yellow on the brush. I haven't really mixed it, so I wanted to see if I just put it on like that, it will create fire. It has
That's not bad. Not bad, is it?
Then you can use using a bit of the red and brown and yellow. Make a dirty, horrible colour for the face. We can use a bit more of the colour and we can get the shape of the face more light on it. Get some of that hair. Need is a small brush. Some of this dark just to separator. Pick up a bit of the orange. Just sit back, have a look at it, and then work out what is changing. That's not too bad.
move that colour a bit.
Light on it. Something like that. Hint of that colour hitting the shoe there. And I can use the opposite, the blue and white. Get that one side. Pocket. And then some of that warmth on the rock there. This rock there as well. Not too much though. Keep things fairly dark still. Leave it like that. Kind of want him to have a bright edge to his face. We'll leave it at that. We'll carry on with the water. So we've got the character in. A little bit of colour in there. Now I fancy messing about. Just wipe my hand that's covered in paint. Absolutely covered. A little bit of the baby wipe, I'll do that. Sort that out. And we can start splashing some water around. The character isn't perfect. I can see some things I can do to improve it. Like, thinking about his rib cage there. Indication. Now we can have some fun, do some water. So I've got the water going, sort of splashing around there, coming down here, behind the character. Bit of a light bit there. Goes round and falling down there, falling down here, and splashing there. Some real down here as well. everywhere. Splashing. It falls down here. Really coming down. So I'm going a bit brighter for certain areas. And here as well. Brilliant. It's all slowing down here. Come down there as well. Show the face enough. Do I need to overdo it more or not? It's tricky. Don't want to overdo it. I want it to be kind of a sort of a second view-ish kind of thing. Sometimes that works. If you look twice. sit back, have a look at that, see if anywhere I can improve upon it.
Quite enjoyed painting this, actually.
There is areas I can improve. I can see some splashes of water that's going down here. Okay. I think we're about there, to be honest. Quite like what I got. The background needs a bit more to it. This. Back again. I do like that more. A bit more of this blue on the rock as well. Change that rock there. A little bit more to it than like that. Yeah, quite like that. Maybe I have to shrink his head a bit more. Maybe I could get a bit more of that red. Anyway, I think I'll call that, because I quite like what I've got. And I'll keep him... I'll keep him not too detailed. He's going to look better otherwise. If I make him too detailed... I'll have to really go for it. Can I do? What was something else I was thinking of? Is a few little additional. Keeping it simple. Something else I can do. I'm really going for this. Some of this blue into the water like this. Not that keen on that, really. Get rid of it. I things flowing instead. I do like the addition of that colour in the water, though. Happy accident. Okay, I think I'll go with that. Oh, we ain't got that tree in it. Let's put that tree in it. Put the tree there. I think I'll go with that. So thanks very much for watching this one. I've still got time. I wondered how much time I've used up. I could keep going and going, but you've got to stop at some point. It's a bit of a fun one, bit of a made-up scene using photos and digital art. Putting it all together. Something interesting. Yeah, I really enjoyed doing this one. It's good fun. So I'll say, actually, the one thing I want to do. Want to put a little bit of light there. And I can actually do this. Yeah, well, stop there, because we're going to mess it up. So I'm going to wipe my brush. I'll give it a little JV, I think. A little JV down here. So thanks very much for watching this one. Hope you got you inspired by ideas that you can do, and Hopefully, I'll see you at another one. So thanks very much for watching this one. If you enjoyed it, don't forget to subscribe. Don't forget, because I'm going to do more paintings. There's always more paintings coming. And you might get inspired to do something of your own. So thanks very much for watching, and I'll see you in another one. Cheers, bye.